All right, so I'm going to be talking about the day services options we have here at the St. Louis ARC. We actually have three distinct programs now, which is different in the past. We used just to call it day program, or you may have heard it called CE in the past, but we've really kind of branched out and created a couple different programs for different audiences. And those programs are our community engagement program. You may have heard that called community integration in the past. It is now called community engagement. Our aging with empowerment program and our learning independence for tomorrow program. And that's our newest. We are coming up on our 1 year anniversary. We opened that in February of 2021. So each program, there's a lot that they have in common and some things that are different, but what's a commonality between all of the programs really are our goals and values. They are all community-based programs. How often people spend or how the length of time in the community can vary program to program, but they are all community-based. They all work on fostering inclusion with the community, with their loved ones, natural supports. We focus heavily on outcome achievement and growth. So every single person in every single one of our programs are gonna set some very specific goals for themselves and what they want to get out of this program. And that's gonna guide the activities that we do. We get out, we have a lot of fun, but we're always also working on some very specific goals. So there's a deeper level of meaning to what we're doing as well. And we offer small support ratios in all of our programs. They vary from program to program, but the most you'll see is typically a 1 to 3 average ratio. So for a quick reference, I'm going to show you this one pager, which shows you all of our three programs and kind of shows you exactly how they're the same, how they're different, but I'll also do a deep dive into each one of them. So our community engagement program is kind of our most active. Those are best for people who love to be out in the community on a daily basis and for a very good portion of their day. Of the 6 hour day, you're going to be spending between 4 and 5 hours out in the community. We have our Aging with Empowerment program that is geared towards seniors, although what constitutes a senior can be a little bit flexible. So we really look more towards energy level and what people want to get out of the program. So we get out every day usually as well, but maybe for shorter periods of time, maybe for 1 to 2 hours at a time, build in more opportunities for some rest, more interest exploration. We also work on a lot of memory care supports in that program as it is designed to support older individuals and have a little bit more opportunity to provide more intensive medical supports in that program as well. And then the Learning Independence for Tomorrow program is designed for individuals that have some behavioral support needs. This program is designed to be a transition program, so we hope that you won't stay in it forever, but that folks can come in, really do some intensive skill development, skill building, kind of work through whatever barriers might keep them from a traditional job or a more traditional day program, work through those, and then move on to something else. We purposefully did not set a set time period that people had to leave in that program because we know that's really going to vary. So we have some folks that have been with us about 6 months and are getting close to being ready to move on. We have others that's probably going to be several years, and that's perfectly okay. So you can see our age range is 18 plus for everybody except for our Aging with Empowerment program. That's older adults. What older looks like to you and me can be flexible. And our support ratios are a little bit different. They're 1 to 1 to 1 to 4 in our community engagement and aging with empowerment, although the average is 1 to 3. And then in learning independence for tomorrow, those folks will need a little bit more intensive and focused support. So we either do 1 to 1 or 1 to 2 in that program and no more than that. So to get into a little bit of an overview of our community engagement program, which I just started talking about, we do support adults with developmental disabilities to get out in the community every single day, with rare exceptions. If the weather's really crummy or something else is going on that's really exciting, that's site-based, but pretty much we are going to be out on a daily basis. While we're out, we generally do a mix of leisure, volunteer, and educational activities. How much of each is going to be up to the individual and what they want to get out of the program. So some folks might be focused on maybe getting a job down the line and we'll focus more on volunteerism or working on some soft skills. Other folks might work on more social recreational goals, or you can do a mix of everything. So really what you want and need, we can really individualize and tailor. But as we said, everybody sets some very specific goals, and that's what's going to guide the activities we do. Even if we're doing something fun, like going to a Cardinals game, we could still be working on budgeting for that overpriced hot dog and soda, or patience while waiting in line, or whatever else you might be working on within your day. We have 5 locations in the St. Louis area. We are in the Central West End, Creve-Coeur, Hazelwood, Maplewood, and Town and Country. So we are in kind of most corners of St. Louis. Most people choose to go to the site that's closest to where they live. You do not have to do that. All of the same programs have the same, excuse me, all of the programs have the same basic structure, but there are different people, different personalities at each site. So you might find that you fit in more or enjoy one more than the other, and you're welcome to attend that. I do want to put in the caveat that if you are looking to get transportation funded through the Department of Mental Health, they're usually only going to transport a certain number of distance from your home. So if you want to go a little further, you can, but you might have to get yourself to and from that program. And as we said, participants usually begin and end their day at the site, but a majority of the time is out and about. It's a very active program. We are on the go. Even though we do have a program for older individuals, there's no age limit. We have some folks in their late 70s in that program, and they have more energy than I do or any of the 20-year-olds, so they can keep going to that one. So you certainly don't ever have to age out.